What? Really? Okay. How we going, everybody? I've been doing some gardening today, cleaning up the garden beds here. Yes, I love you, sweetheart. Okay, it's my turn now. That's enough tickles. We've taken out a lot of weeds around the outside. I'm turning over some of the garden beds. This stuff here, as you can see, is the kale. I've dug that out from the other trench on the opposite side. Now, what I'm going to end up doing with these garden beds is going to raise them. I'm going to actually lift them up about 400 high because it's just drying out too quick. The tree roots from the conifers and the yuccas at the back there are just sucking the ground completely dry. Yeah, the grass is moist, but that's very shallow rooted, whereas these plants here are drying up. Don't look at the wilt on them because they were just freshly transplanted. We spoke about self-germinated plants and there's some kale there. So the whole garden bed's been cleared, well, almost cleared. I'm working my way through the potatoes. Now, I've been using the ashwood tools, the hand tools. This is the little tulip trowel with the shark tooth edge. Perfect, because it gets right underneath and cuts off any extra roots that you don't need. The cultivator, I love this little tool as well. Let me just show you how well it works. This here, for example, this is a hard surface. I haven't dug this over. This here just rips into it so easily, loosens up the surface, especially when you're walking in the garden. Like, I've had to walk through here, and you can see I've made a little stockpile of weeds that I've got to take out. Now, this is the garden bed I've got to dig over still, slowly working my way back into the veggie garden. Into the potatoes. That's all these potatoes here, and I'm weeding all that out. So walking around here has compacted the surface. Well, not so much there, but it has over here. So scratching it, see how it just breaks it up? And it helps you dig out weeds too. Let me find you a section. Where is it? Oh, well, here, I haven't finished here. So you can loosen up all the roots just like this by scratching over the surface rather than just trying to pull it out in one go. And you get most of the roots out more so this way than you would by just pulling out the roots on a hard surface. Now, this is what I've been doing all day, breaking up the soil. Look at that. How cool is that? Loosens up the rest of it and it all just comes out. So I've got to do the rest of this by hand. And I'm going to take out these spring onions, but also these are the other tools. Now, you remember the little tea spade I showed you a few days ago or weeks ago? Great little tool, a little shovel with a couple of sawtooths on the side. Check out these ones here. Look at this little beauty. This is what they call a planting shovel or planting spade. It's a completely different shape to your typical spade. Well, not different, very narrow, so you can create small deep holes if you like, and I like to dig sort of square holes, but I like the curve on it because it actually helps you capture some of the soil and the curve there. So I'm talking about the curve here as a plate so you can hold the soil, plus the curved edge which cuts into the soil, so it's not a square mouth or a flat one. I haven't tried this yet, first time. Oh, look at that. Just takes it up real easy. Not a bad shovel. Actually, it's quite good. Really good for planting pot plants like trees if you have, or 10-inch pots, for example. I'm going to do some of that tomorrow. We'll demonstrate this properly tomorrow. This is what I used earlier on, the garden fork. Now, I've had garden forks, plenty of them in my time, and this one here is quite curved. See the curve on that? It's a lot more normally. Let me go and get another one for you so you can see the difference. This is an old one that I've got. One second. Okay, this is one that's it's been around the block a few times, folks. I've actually broken it. So let's say that's about straight there. Just going to compare the curve on it. Because it feels different, this one, when I use it. Yeah, it's got more curve. That doesn't look like much more there, but I'll tell you something, there's a huge difference when you're handling it. Now, when you put it in, if you want to go straight down, for example, I found this really easy to use. Unusual at the beginning when I started with it, because I had to have this sort of a lean on it, because I wanted to get my forks in straight down. But you can go on a slight angle like that and push in. Now, that's sitting straight up there. So easy, and you don't have to lean over down here because the forks have got that extra curve on them from the handle just to break up the soil. Just so easy. And if you don't want to turn the soil over, it's a great way to aerate it. And then just go around and just break it up like that. This is what I found it to be so good for. Loosening up the soil, not having to turn it over, but the curve on the other side just breaks it up. And it is heavy, top heavy. So all the weight is obviously in the head here, in the fork, in the tines. Now that's the larger one, and these are the other ones. This is the smaller pair. So that one there we just showed you earlier is a larger, well, that's a digging spade, and this is a border spade, that's what it's called, and that's a border garden fork, or garden fork, or border fork. So let's compare the two. So that's, this is cute. One second, let me start with a fork. Wow, there is a big difference. That's what we're gonna do. Same curve on them, same length, just a bigger head on the, in the forks. And I reckon it'll do just as good a job, and it's probably good around the edges. I've got no edge here, this is a big garden bed. But you can get around little spots. Oh, how cute is that? Just in between the potatoes, just to break up the surface. It is really good, this is a good fork. And the little spade, I haven't ever worked with the little spade because I always thought they were a little bit too little for me. But after using the T-spade, this border spade, I reckon if you've got raised garden beds, my garden beds are all planted out at the moment. I can't really test it out for you there. But we can go over here and check out the sides. Let's go over here, come on. It's just good for breaking up the soil around the edges as well if you want. Or if you want to stick your foot into it. Just a really easy tool to use. Now, if you need to dig some small holes, you've got the digging spade, and this is a border spade, that's what it's called. So I'm imagining it's around the borders. But, you know, just a small spade so you can do a little bit of a turnover or loosening up the soil. And this is what I use my spades with for, you know, just breaking it up like that. You can see we've got the thyme here, and these are the endives I transplanted earlier. Been starting on this garden bed, so the broad beans are doing well, the parsley's kicking on really well. Obviously the broccoli's been destroyed by the chickens, so they haven't been allowed back in here anymore. So the endives have come here. We've got gotchacolla, whatever you call that. One's a memory herb. That looks like a weed down here. Look at this one down here. That's a memory herb. And that one there's the arthritis herb or something like that. Not that I have arthritis yet. And these are lettuces, like we did the other time. Self-germinated lettuce. Have a look at all this. We've got another feed there for another month to go on. And spring onions going on. So, tools, folks, if you're only as good as the tools you use in your garden. You can dig with your hands as much as you like, and I do a lot of digging by hand. Look, practice hygiene if you're really concerned about the microbes and the whatever stuff's in your soil. If you're using fertilizers and chemicals like that, non-organic synthetic stuff, by all means, always use gloves. Everything I put in my garden comes out of the back ass of a chicken or a sheep, or it's composted by worms and or the garden bed itself, so I'm quite confident in that respect. But when it comes to digging, you really need the right tools to be able to do it. And I'll tell you something, these Ashwood range here, I'm loving them. I've used a lot of tools in my time, and this stuff here seems to be pretty good. It's not a commercial grade, so don't expect to be doing, you know, moving boulders with your tools, but I can tell you something, you'll enjoy using them in the garden as I have today. And I've done a bit of trialing out there, especially with the hand tools. We'll go back to the garden forks over here. So what we're gonna do here, like I said earlier, look at that, look what I've done. Just taken out a bloody potato. Good on you, Vasily. You bloody idiot. It's chitting. Now, folks, I think we may have a few left still. They're only $2 a kilo, our potatoes, seed potatoes. You can plant them in the ground because most of them will be chitting like this already, which means they've sprouted. I'm gonna put this back in the ground now. Which ones do you think I should use? I'll use a little planting, the border spade, that's the one. Stick it in, cover it over. That's how easy it is to plant your potatoes, folks. This is the hers, that's the his. Well, actually, maybe this is the hers and that's the his. It can, whatever way you like it, really. Garden isn't gender specific, folks. You know, each to their own. If you like the big set, go for the big set, or go for the small set. In actual fact, it's Father's Day in a couple of weeks. What a great idea for Father's Day gift. You can get a pair of these, and we'll throw in a little hand trowel as well, folks. So if you go with the large or the small set, either way, you'll get a free hand trowel to go with. It's the Ashwood range. You're not gonna, well, there are better products out there, but you're gonna pay a hell of a lot more for them. So for the money you get, you're gonna get a top range here that's gonna last you almost a lifetime. Look after them well, I do with my little hand tools, and you'll never go to another pair of tools anywhere again. Check it all out at vasilisgarden.com. We are running our special still, folks. Lockdown is doing our heads in, as it is for everybody else out there. So we're still keeping our prices down low for everybody to be able to shop at the cheapest price ever. You'll never get anything cheaper again for your garden, so you can enjoy a little bit of respite in your own backyard as I'm doing here. And at the end of the day, you don't have to rely on the supermarkets to feed you. Your own garden is your own supermarket. All you got to do is walk out your door door, from your back door there, go to your little veggie garden, however big or small it is, and feed yourself and the family. So the bigger the space, enjoy the more produce you can get out of it. Fruit as well, and even flowering. So if you love your flowers, plant them out there. They make you feel good. They make me feel good. I love vegetables. I can't get enough of them, inside, outside, and even visually. So that's why we're keeping our prices down for you. So black root is discounted 70%. Everything online is up to 70% off, including the secret code. So you chuck that in, you get an extra 20% off the price. That is dirt cheap. I mean, we can't get it any cheaper than that. We're giving it away. Check it all out, facilitiesgarden.com. Until tomorrow, we'll do some planting. Marisi.